हाय स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल थॉट्स ऑफ फिजिक्स।
इन द वीडियो सीरीज ऑफ रे ऑप्टिक्स, इन दिस क्लास आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ थिन लेंसेस इन कॉन्टैक्ट एंड इक्विवेलेंट फोकल लेंथ ऑफ द कॉम्बिनेशन। फॉर दैट लेट अस कंसीडर टू थिन कॉन्वेक्स लेंसेस विच आर प्लेस्ड कोएक्सियली। सो लेट्स कंसीडर टू थिन कॉन्वेक्स लेंसेस। दिस इज कॉन्वेक्स लेंस Okay, these are the two thin convex lenses which are placed coaxially. So let us label the two lenses as A and B. A, B are the two lenses and these are placed coaxially, that is the principal axis. This is the common principal axis for the two lenses. Common principal axis for the two lenses. Let us label the two lenses as A and B. And the focal lengths of the two lenses, let us say F1 and F2. F1 is the focal length of A lens, F2 is the focal length of B lens. So let us consider an object O is placed on the principal axis. An object O is placed on the principal axis. Now, a light ray from this object, which is traveling along the principal axis. It travels along the principal axis means it is passing through the optic center, common optic center. So it does not deviate. So it does not deviate, it travels in the same direction. Now another light ray which incident on the lens A. This is another light ray which incident on the lens A. So for time being, let us imagine there is no lens B. In the absence of lens B, if there is no B lens, due to the refraction, the lens A, the light ray from the lens A, it travels like this and it touches the principal axis at this point, touches the principal axis at that particular point. So let us say this point is labeled as I dash. So what is I dash here means? I dash is the image formed by A lens in the absence of B lens. I dash is the image formed by A lens in the absence of B lens. For example, if there is no B lens, only if there is A lens, it forms the image I dash. Now, if you take B lens in combination with A lens, then the image formed by this A lens I dash, it acts as virtual object for the B lens. This I dash image, it is image formed by A lens itself. This form, it acts as virtual object for the B lens. So finally, the image formed due to the combination, the image formed at, let us say this is I. Okay. Now, I dash is image formed by A lens itself in the absence of B lens. And the image formed by A lens I dash, it acts as virtual object for the B lens. Virtual object for the B lens, and I is the image formed by this B lens. So that means this is the figure. Next, to obtain the equivalent focal length of this combination, so let us take the thin lens formula. Now we know thin lens formula. Now let us take the thin lens formula, that is 1 by V minus 1 by U, that is equal to 1 by F. In this formula, V is image distance, U is object distance, F is focal length. Image distance, object distance, and F is focal length. So let us apply this thin lens formula for both the lenses individually, that is for A lens and for B lens. Now, let us apply thin lens formula for A lens. By applying thin lens formula. By applying thin lens formula for the lens A, I am applying thin lens formula. Now, if you observe A lens, for A lens object is O. O is the object for A lens. Due to the A lens, in the absence of B lens, the image is I dash. That means for A lens object is O, image is I dash. From the common optic center, let us draw the distances. Let us find the distances. So, the distance of the object from this common optic center, that is U, object distance. The distance of image from the common optic center, the distance, final image, that is V. The distance of I dash from the common optic center, that is, let us say, V dash. Now, from the common optic center, we have taken the distances. Now, by applying thin lens formula for the lens A. For the lens A, now let us apply this formula. Here 1 by V, V is the image distance. For the lens A, image is I dash. So, image distance is V dash. So, you can write 1 by V dash minus. Here U is object distance. For the lens A, object is at O. So, object distance is U. That's why you can write this one as 1 by U. 1 by V dash minus 1 by U. That is equal to, here F is focal length. The focal length of A lens is F1. So that's why it can be written as 1 by F1. Let it be equation number 1. Similarly, let us apply the thin lens formula for the B lens also. Now by applying thin lens formula, by applying thin lens formula for the lens B. Right. Now let us see the B lens. For B lens, object is I dash. Because the image formed by A lens, it acts as virtual object for B lens. So for B lens, image is I dash. So for B lens, object is I dash. So, object distance for the B lens is V dash. For B lens, image is I. So, for B lens, image distance is V. So, for B lens, object is I dash. So, for B lens, object distance is V dash. For B lens, image is at I. So, image distance is V. Now, if you apply that, 1 by V. V is image distance. So, image for B is I. So, 1 by V. Minus U is object distance, for B lens object distance is V dash. So minus 1 by V dash, that is equal to F is focal length. The focal length of B lens is F2, so that you can write 1 by F2. Let it be equation number 2. Now we got the two equations by applying thin lens formula for the lens A and B separately. Now let us add the two equations by adding the first E and second equations. So that is 1 plus 2. We are adding the two equations. By adding the two equations, left hand side we have 1 by V dash minus 1 by U, first equation. So that is 1 by V dash minus 1 by U. So if you add that to the second equation left hand side is 1 by V minus 1 by V dash. So plus 1 by V minus 1 by V dash. So, left hand terms we have added first equation and second equation. That is equal to, similarly if we add the right hand terms also, first equation right hand side is 1 by F1. Second equation right hand side is 1 by F2. So, if we add the two terms, 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2. In this expression, this is 1 by V dash, this is minus 1 by V dash get cancelled. And this is minus 1 by U, this is plus 1 by U. If you arrange and if you write in order, that is 1 by V, positive term first. 1 by V minus 1 by U. That is equal to 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2. Let it be equation number 3. Now, so let us replace the two lenses, A, B lenses, with an equivalent lens. So, what is equivalent lens means? A single lens which produces the same effect as produced by the combination of lenses. That means, whatever the effect produced by the two lenses, the single lens will give the same effect. So, equivalent lens means a single lens which produces the same effect as produced by the combination of lenses. So, that's why. Now, let us apply the combination of lenses formula. Now, this is the equivalent lens. Let us say this is equivalent lens. Its focal length is F. Now, let us take the principal axis. Now, this is the object O as it is. Now, from this object, a light ray traveling along the principal axis, along the optic center, it does not deviate. And the second light ray which incident on the lens and it forms the image at point I. Okay, this is equivalent lens. Its focal length is F. Now, for this, the object distance, let us take the object distance is U, and for this, the image distance is V. Now, what we have done here, it is the two lenses, AB lenses, replaced by a single lens. Okay, for this lens, object is at a distance of U, and it forms the image at a distance of V. Its focal length is F. For this, if you apply the thin lens formula again, that we will get 1 by image distance is V only, minus 1 by object distance is U for this equivalent lens, is equal to its focal length is 1 by F. Now, let it be equation number 4. So, by comparing the two, third equation and fourth equation. So, if you see left hand side, 1 by V minus 1 by U. Fourth equation, left hand side also 1 by V minus 1 by U. That means, by equating the two equations, equation number 3 is equal to equation number 4. Then, we will get, so if you, left hand side, both the terms are same. If you equate the right hand side terms, that is, 1 by F is equal to, so 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2. That is, the equivalent focal length, that is 1 by F is the reciprocal of the equivalent focal length. The reciprocal of the equivalent focal length is equal to the sum of reciprocals of individual focal lengths. F1 and F2 are the focal lengths of the individual lenses. So, the reciprocal of the focal length is equal to sum of reciprocals of individual focal lengths. Individual focal length. Now, if you apply this formula for n number of lenses, if you apply this formula for n number of lenses, then you will get the formula 1 by F. 1 by F is equal to 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2 plus and so on plus 1 by Fn. You can apply this formula for n number of lenses. That means the reciprocal of the equivalent focal length is equal to the sum of the reciprocals of focal lengths of individual lenses. So, this is the combination of thin lenses in contact and the equivalent focal length of the combination.
If you have any doubts, you can ask in the comment section. For latest updates, subscribe and click the bell icon.